Draw a little character. Silver. You know, I downloaded that new globular. Should check it out. I have to unzip it though really quick. I forgot about it. I should be a little more prepared. I'm always never prepared. Alright, no, desktop. That's what I figured would happen. Entangled everything. Why does it never just work? G G G G. Can't remember how to spell. Glob, 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 glob. Euler. Ay, ay, ay. There you go. See how this one sounds. I thought I downloaded a second one. Unconfirmed download. Maybe I need to open it back up. Oh, it's still open. Couldn't download, huh? Let's try it again. Oh no, that's a different one. I wanted this one. Eh, we'll let that one download in the background. Alright. Welcome to the stream. We are streaming. Ay, ay, ay. That was part of my reference. Wow, I'm really bad at this. I just wanted to see whether or not those things are coming up or not. Doesn't look like it. All right. Some good stuff. I'll leave that. All right. Now that I got 50 million things open and running, let's see if I can figure out how to draw something. No guarantees. I've been putting together all these, just, you know, tons of different character references I've been wanting to do, or character drawings, and It's more to just get the, hopefully the feel of the character right, you know, to get that way by the time I'm really putting these things down on board. Well, I don't know if I'll be putting them on board or not, but technically, at least virtual board. I want to be able to have a comfortable good relationship with proportions, how the character is, you know, especially you know, I was talking before about Loomis's 5 C's, concept, construction, contour, character, and consistency. And character, you know, it's a big thing, you know. I know people know it is, but I think sometimes we like to let other things take over, especially seems like in comics these days. A lot of the guys I see out there, maybe not so much pros, but guys who want to be pros, they always seem to they care about the consistency, the last one first. You know, everything is they you know, they'll have all this shading, you know, and if they don't exit, you know, then it's all perfectly shaded in. Not like that, but I mean like perfectly shaded in, and it's all one consistent gray, everything just kind of melds together. And I understand why they're doing it. You know, Shrest did it back in the day, and everybody's been trying to copy his success since then. And head's a little small. I'd rather redraw it, but I kind of like the head I got. One, two, three, four. Okay, so I'm gonna go all the way down to there. No, I wasn't. I'm saying sorry. I got deep and lost in the construction here, or the concept of this. They spend so much time on the consistency But consistency has to be subordinate to the character, and then the character has to be subordinate to the contour, to the construction, to the concept. So it's never the opposite way. You don't start with, you consistently shaded it great. Oh, but there's no character in their face. You know, it's everybody looks exactly the same. Everybody looks plastic. And then you can't have everybody look plastic because, well, if they do, then obviously you didn't spend any good time getting the contours of the figure right, or you didn't get the construction right, because you jumped from concept straight to consistency. You gotta start with the concept, and you'll find that you'll probably breeze through concept. You'll start breezing through construction and contour. Before you know it, you're in the character and consistency really quick. But if you aren't putting down strong construction and contours, then it doesn't matter how much consistency at the end, how much shading at the end you do, it's always going to look horrible. People will like it, you'll get some great DeviantArt like, you know, but it's all because they like the shading of it, or pretty much a lot of times all they really care about is the fact that it was Batman or Wonder Woman, you know, or something, you know. They really, people, you know, they really don't care sometimes. So maybe, you know, it doesn't matter. But if you want your art, I think, to last a long time, these are principles that you really got to start laying down. You got to do it at the beginning, because it'll only get worse. And you don't want to be old and in the business and realizing, oh man, this stuff looks horrible, and then you're trying to fix decades of bad drawings, and you're wondering why nobody's ever hiring you. You know, I've had to do that. I learned to draw from comic books. I didn't think learning fundamentals was important. I just did that consistency stuff, and I've had to go back and learn how to draw, because I just thought all that other stuff was what made great looking comics, but all I was doing was copying somebody else's art style. Which, I was at Comic-Con 1 year with my portfolio a long time ago, and one of the DC editor guys came out and was talking about portfolio submissions and said, you know, they better be great, and if they're not great, don't show it to us. He's like, and you know if it's great or not. Hey, Stoller 13. Hey, thanks. He's like, you know if it's good. Don't bring us bad artwork. Oh, and he's like, we don't want to see, you know, your best Jim Lee impression. We don't want to see your best Todd McFarlane, because if I want to do a book that has a Todd McFarlane look or Jim Lee book, I'll just go hire those guys, you know? It was a little eye opening. It was like, oh, well, okay. I think I need to move that arm back. Not always the biggest fan of doing this, but sometimes speed is of the essence. See, normally, and I'm fighting it right now because I really want to go up and start drawing the face. But there's no point in drawing that face yet until I get this all constructed properly. Get this part down that way. Then when I do go and draw the face, then it will actually kind of want that over to, I want to see a little bit more of her belt. See what happens here. Alright, let's I do think I have her torso a little big though. Dang it, you know. See anybody else's 27 QHD have such. I wonder if I have. No, this is. Snap to special ruler. Maybe that's my problem. I wonder if that's on by default. I need to go in somewhere and figure out how to turn that off. I always have problems. It always seems like I never get a nice clean line. Hopefully. Some of this stuff can be tackled more, but later. It's really gotta see in my reference though, this isn't that long. I don't know if it's because she's shorter. to... I mean, yeah, it's probably a little bit shorter, but... See, I want to fix these problems now. Instead of later. As they say, I want to kill this darling now. Because what I don't want to have to do. Come at it later. I almost get, and that kind of disappears in. Size. Okay. Maybe. Might be close enough, but I'm not sure. Probably not, but I guess all I need. Actually, I don't need this one, do I? Keep forgetting her pants are. So where's this high? Wasted things. These big buttons. One of her outfits is the outfit I'm putting it in. This one in. This time. So the belt will hang low. She has this. I saw this crazy picture on Pinterest where this girl wore this interesting under. This. It's like she was just wearing the underwire from the bra, but it was made out of gold, so it was almost like jewelry. Maybe. it so we can really get the character. I'm not always the best at this, so I need help with getting in tighter. Hopefully. head too big. No, I just need to widen out her shoulders a little bit. Thank you. tangent. Thank you. to stretch for a second. Oh. Hopefully it's at least aren't look like the same person. All three of these, hopefully they look like the same girl, just in different outfits. Bunch of tangents may possibly happening. Yeah, see, fix all that so we don't get a bunch of tangents all happening there at the same place. Bad at drawing circles lately. Thank you. shoulder hurts. I'm not used to drawing as much. I just think of that line from Tombstone. I'm here, Huckleberry. Numb bum. Oh, my bum is numb. Oh. Like I said, it's been a having to get back into drawing and
Nikes.
Oh, that's sore. Thank you. See how I got rid of that tangent? Didn't know there was a tangent there. Maybe everybody's seen it for the last hour and just been waiting for me to finally get rid of it. Horrible foot, but I can fix that later. Looks like we lost our music. Let's try this other album, see what it was like. Bring it over here. Still have that going. Hopefully I wasn't getting feedback. Probably. Let's see. Copy. New folder. I'll paste these. Keep that open. We'll see how this sounds. Wonder if I need to change her pants to more of her style that I have in the book. Oh, that's those. Duplicate. Let's do this. Put that over top. Putting her a skirt like that. It's kind of interesting. This is a duplicate. is something about just... bell bottoms. Maybe the bell bottoms do work. It's definitely different. Does look a little nicer, not so dark, a little more sketchy, huh? Okay, what was I just thinking? Seriously, was just thinking something. Oh, what was I thinking of doing? Guess it wasn't important. Oh, that's what I was gonna do. I was thinking about checking my accuracy against the original. Now that I've done that, here's my original reference. Should be safe for here. See how horribly I drew this. Hopefully it wasn't too bad. And I did change some of her size. Should be, I think I did definitely elongate her, so just placeholders. Maybe that's part of my problem, my picture. I can check that in mine. Alright, let's turn this off. Turn mine back on. Let's lower the opacity a lot. And we can... Is that the one I just did? Wow, way up there. Alright, let's see. too bad. It looks like this would have gone in here like that. I think it needs to come a little bit smaller. Fits the head just a tad bit better. All right, so I know I made her got the shoulders in the right spot. Arms a little bit farther out, but then I don't think I lengthened her that much, but I guess I did. Like I said, I think the model was shorter than my actual character, so this part's a little off, but then it would be down just a tad bit. See what would happen if I go all the way down. There we go. And then we yeah, that's not so bad. Eyes getting better, that's for sure. I'm not as far off as I was on the last drawing that I did, so I feel pretty good about that. Here's my reference for her, for the face. Let's do a quick one of that. Blow it up. So once again, these aren't supposed to take over the drawing experience. This is supposed to just be a way to check the accuracy of how your eye is seeing, so that as you start to draw, you get, you know, more, you can draw more efficiently, you'll be faster. It's all about being fast. We want you to be faster, want you to be accurate. We want, you know, the reference is there to help guide you. It's not, you know, oh, I want that. All right, now see how off I was. Looks like I probably made her nose too small. I like to usually line up the eyes. Let's see, where I have her eye right now is about that size. Her right eye. Huh. Which means I got her face off. Lips too high. Nose a little low here. Not as wide as it's supposed to be. See, the way I have it. Put the head there. See, I match up better this way with the left eye. My mouth is too low and that eye is too far over to the left, and her face isn't wide enough. Thank you. can see the eyes too far over. And her mouth was too low. Wrong thing, that's why. And her face was a little, needs to be a little bit wider because, well, darn it, she's just wrong color. So now, I didn't realize how far off her nose was, see? Hey, wrong. See, that's what I want. This is how I want you to use your, be utilizing your reference. I want to utilize your reference. It's there to build your skill up, not as a crutch. Eventually, I should get to the point where I'm going to have that down and I won't have to rely so much on this stuff. What difference will that make? Thank you. I had to decide whether or not I wanted to keep this buckle or not down here, right here. Whether or not to keep this buckle, and I think I'll like it. So I can go ahead and moving this arm did make a difference, though. Really gave the gesture of her hips turning this way, and, you know. And her pulling that out, I noticed on my reference that was actually it's not supposed to be 100% representation, although I do really like that pose. But I do like how it turned out. So I had to use my reference, do the trace over to get the construction right. You know, I had the concept, I put the construction in, and I had to get those contours right. And sometimes you have to, you know, I think I'd rather have you do that method to get your drawing a little bit more accurate. See that? By doing that, it made me realize that that was open there. That really twists her hips around. Really gives that pulling back. A much better feel. I'm here, Huckleberry. Best lines ever in the history of cinema. I'm gonna get rid of these little things. They don't need to be there. You know, that's the best part. You start learning how some of these master illustrators worked, and that's the number one thing all the good ones had in common that I'm having to try to figure out is, when do you just get rid of stuff? I mean, your brain is like, no, it's right there, so it has to be in the picture. And you're like, does it really? Had the guys who taught me, they used to say stuff like that. Does it? Are you sure? And I'm like, yeah, it's right there. So, but, and I'm like, well, if it's messing up your picture, or it's causing a tangent, see, in real life, and in the photograph, it happened because, you know, it's just real life, so, nobody cares about the tangent. But on a static figure, all of a sudden, your eye just laser beams to stuff like that. And you don't know why something's wrong. You don't understand why it's not looking good. Chances are, you have a bunch of tangents in your picture. What? That's it. Copy, paste. something like that. It should be drawn better. Oh. Wrist is awful tiny. Not that adulterers aren't usually... that many. Ugh. Well, as a sketch goes, it's pretty sketchy. Oh, I have gotten kind of in a rut lately of not being able to stay focused enough to really finish them. But... I'm also trying to, as an excuse, leave it a little bit looser because I want it to have a feeling of looseness. And, you know, eventually it'd be nice when, you know, and then when I ink it, it helps me to not have to be so dogmatic about staying exactly on the exact line that I'm on. And I can catch a line here, I can catch a line there, I can exaggerate, push, so. Think about the only thing I could really do with this one now is probably try to do something with her face a little bit better. also been trying to do is I keep telling myself I need to turn it on, but I still haven't done it. There's a setting within. I can go in and set the max resolution. So you can set that it will only zoom out so far. Not max resolution, but max zoom. I watched a webinar from ImagineFX. No, Clip Studio. That a guy who uses this for doing his comics. It's the setting, he would put his max zoom at only 150. Right now, it says I'm at 87. But 150 would only allow me to go technically here with this much detail, which is a lot. But I was noticing that I was zooming in way too close on my actual panel work. Because when I zoom out, the drawings are starting to get all kind of muddied. Just too much. I've been watching Icon. Oh, that looks so much better. Icon. I'm horrible at names. It's on YouTube, on Twitch here. He would leave his videos up. He only streams, and then he doesn't like leave his streams there for replay, so unless you catch him live, you ain't seeing it. And oh man, but he does everything zoomed out, one resolution, or one, like, he'll do this whole drawing and put at that size, which, it's just like drawing on paper, and I applaud him for being able to do that. That is amazing. Me, I have to cheat and zoom in. Just to make it feel like I've got got something right. And he's over there just Just follow him on Instagram too. His stuff's amazing. Let me see what his probably not gonna be able to find him very quickly. Probably hasn't posted for a day or two. You know what else might help? I'm gonna go to Twitch. Sometimes I am following Iconic Art. Is his name. That's his Instagram name. And freaking amazing. Yeah, so you can find him on Instagram, I think, under the same name, Iconic Art. Amazing how you stream in cycles. You know, you go for a while and then all of a sudden you're not streaming and then you do. And so there's three different poses and outfits for Silver from Shattered Time. Sometime in the books, these will be some of the things we'll see her in. I'm just trying to build up a visual library of stuff for her. And I just need to get familiar with drawing her face. I need to get more familiar with drawing. I've been using Farrah Fawcett, an actress from the 70s and 80s. She used to be on the original Charlie's Angels. So, she's Farrah Fawcett, and the guy is John Wayne. So, I think that's an interesting couple. And the book's called Rat's Nest. It's coming. It's a nice space opera of a couple just trying to make it together in a crazy world. All right. Well, I think that's going to be it for right now. Maybe I'll come back up. I always say that. Maybe I'll come back up and do some more. My butt's killing me. And we are getting ready. Thanksgiving's coming up, and we have to do a little bit of traveling. Yeah, it's a crazy time. You know, it's such a interesting thing to have to try to juxtapose not passing COVID to an elderly person, yet they're advanced elderly to the point where this might be the last Thanksgiving you get to have with them, or the last Christmas. And so It's a tough dilemma for people, and I don't blame people for wanting to be around their loved ones. So, if you do travel, travel safe. Be safe on the roads. Be respectful of others. We'll be wearing our masks. Happy holidays, and thanks for hanging out. Thanks, Stoller13 for the shout out. I appreciate that. I keep forgetting. I need to make sure that I put at the beginning of each stream. I should put a paper up there that says check audio, and then for chat put in please say hello. So thank you and have a good day.